Yes, welcome back. Today we will be dealing the sixth unit from sixth standard Oxford publication book. Okay, and the name of the unit is The Unexplained. So the unexplained, it means that something that cannot be explained. Okay, so here whatever the stories that we are going to deal ends with such a kind that cannot be explained. Okay, so today I will be taking only one chapter, like the first chapter of this unit, and that is Lobb's Girl. Okay, so before that, now there is a word given, supernatural. And what is the meaning of supernatural? Anything that is beyond or above the nature, okay, that is known as supernatural, or that cannot be explained from the laws of the natural world. So this thing is very important that you have to keep in mind. Okay, like the things that cannot be explained from the laws of the natural world, like whenever we say or we speak that whenever there comes a spirit or any such kind of thing, ghost or witches, okay, so all of these are supernatural elements. Okay, this, like, their presence cannot be explained from the laws of the natural world, because in the, what is the law of the natural world? If we know that if someone dies, they can never come back again. Okay, so that's why if they come back, they are known as supernatural thing. And these are mainly fictional thing. So, and that is unexplained. Okay, so this very thing is unexplained, like their arrival. Okay, so this is the main thing that we are going to read. Lobb's Girl. This is the name of the chapter. So read the story about a girl and her loyal companion. So we, with this, it is very clear that it is a story mainly about a girl and her loyal companion. So who is that, this loyal companion? The name of that loyal companion is Lobb. Okay, Lobb. And who is this Lobb? Lobb is the name of a dog, a German Shepherd. Okay, a German Shepherd. So this is a dog, his name is Lobb, and Lobb's Girl, and this is a girl. Now let us take a quick look on the characters. Okay, so what are the characters that are here? So it is very clear that Lobb and a girl. Okay, so Lobb is our German Shepherd, and this girl. So what is the name of the girl? So girl's name is Alexandra. Alexandra. Okay, so the main protagonist of this is Alexandra, and she is also known by the second name, that is Sandy. Okay, so in her home, or we can say that Sandy is the nickname of Alexandra. And this Alexandra is there is a one elder brother who is 12 years old. So name of the elder brother is Don, 12 years old. Sandy, what is the age of Sandy? Sandy is 5 years old. And twins. Okay, and the twins. And what is the name of the twin? Tim and Tess. Okay, Tim and Tess. T-I-M, Tim and Tess. T-A-S-S, Tess. Okay, this you will be finding over here. Now, talking about the father. What is the name of Alexandra's father? So it is Bert Benchley. Okay, Bert Benchley. Now mother's name, mother name is Jean. Okay, so if you wish that you can just write it down, note it down in your notebook. Okay, so just put the heading Lobb's Girl, put the title characters. Okay, and just write whatever the characters I'm saying, so that it will be easier for you to understand. And this time I'm not going to give you a line by line explanation, because the story is quite easy. Okay, this time I will be only dealing with the some important lines that you need to understand and the summary. Okay, so once I will be telling you the summary, that time you will be able to read the chapter by your own. Okay, and do the question answers after that. Yes, yeah. So we have done that. What is the name of the father? Bert. And the mother's name is Jean. Daughter. Daughter name is Alexandra. Brother. Alexandra's brother, who is 12 years old, his name is Don. And twins. Twin. So name of the twin is Tim and Tess. Okay. And the name of the dog, or this German Shepherd, is Lobb. Okay. Some more characters are here. So let us look at them. The more characters, those are in this story. So first one is Aunt Rebecca. Okay, Aunt Rebecca. So who is Aunt Rebecca? Rebecca is the sister of Bert Benchley. It means that who is Bert? Bert is Sandy's father. Okay, so Sandy's father's sister, that is Rebecca. Okay, so I think that it is clear. father. Father name is Bert. Mother, mother name is Jean. Okay. Father's sister. Okay. Father's sister. What is her name? Rebecca. And Rebecca's husband. What is his name? Rebecca's husband is Will Hoskins. W-I-L-S. Will. H-O-S-K-I-N-S. Hoskins. Okay. So that is Rebecca's husband. And what is the name of Jean Pengelly's mother? Okay. Jean Pengelly's mother, she is known by the name Granny Pierce. Granny Pierce, okay. It means that she was the grandmother of Sandy. Granny Pierce, okay. Pierce, P-E-A-R-C-E. Okay, so this much, I think this much is clear to all of you. Yes, there are two more characters. The name is Dr. Travers, T-R-A-V-E-R-S, Dr. Travers, and his wife, Emily. Okay, E-M-I-L-Y. Emily and Dr. Travers. And this dog, at the beginning we will be finding that this dog belongs to someone else, and what is the name of that person whom this dog belong? That is Dr. Dodsworth. Okay, Mr. Dodsworth. This we will be finding here. Mr. Dodsworth. Okay, so Dodsworth is the owner of this dog. Yes. Now let me give you a quick glance of the story. Yeah, at the beginning what happens, that Sandy is a 5 years, we know that, and his brother is given. So this, while Don and Mr. Pengelly, they were just working for their fishing boat. Okay, they used to mainly do fishing and all, and Sandy was supposed to look after the twins. And who are they? Tess and Tim, who have a tendency to get into trouble because they were small, 3 years old. So she is about to check on them when she is tackled by a large dog. So at that time, she was there on the beach, okay, reading her comic book and looking after her brothers, Tim and Tess. That time someone came, and that was a very big dog. Okay, so instead of being upset, she was very delighted, and she was very happy after looking at this dog. Okay, because what happens, when someone comes from behind, that time you used to be very you are afraid. Okay, but that was not the condition with Sandy. She was very happy to find the dog. Okay. And we will find here that at the same moment, a large body struck her forcibly in the midriff as she was covered by flying sand because she was there in the beach. Yes, and what happened at that time, someone was whipping her off. Whipping her off, it means that someone was licking her. And what was that? A warm, rough, damp flannel. Okay, something like a flannel shaped. She opened her eyes and looked. It was a tongue. Okay, so what was that? It was a tongue which was licking her. Licking. Okay, here you can find that the tongue is licking her. Its owner was a large and bouncy young Alsatian or German Shepherd. So whose tongue it was? It was German Shepherd's tongue. And he was having a topaz eyes, black tipped prick ear. Here you will finding the ear, okay, pricked. It means that pointed, a thick soft coat. It means that about her about his fur, and bushy black tipped tail. Okay, and about the tail. So we know that she was very happy, and we find that all the twins, like Tess and Tim and Sandy, they were very happy. They played with Lob, and like they were enjoying their time. At that time what happened, Mr. Dodsworth came, and he asked them for the sorry because he thought that they were scared of him, but they said no, it is very good, like they have enjoyed. Okay, so this much is done. And he told that from where he is, he was from Liverpool, and this Pengelly family lived there at Cornwall, C-O-R-N-W-A-L. Okay, W-A-L-L. So Cornwall is the place where this Pengelly family live, and this Mr. Dodsworth, where he lives in Liverpool. Okay, yes. So it was a Cornish fishing village. It means that Cornwall. Okay, it was a village. And where is Cornwall? It is in southeast England. Okay, so the village was approached by a narrow, steep, twisting hill road. Like the road, it was very twist and turns were there. It was very steep. Okay, it means that it was very deep. So guarded by a notice, and there was a notice written, and just you, if you want, then you can just note it down in your mark it in your book. Okay, this one. Highlighted, low gear for 1.5 miles, dangerous to cyclist. It means that there was a low gear. It was the drivers of the vehicle. They were asked to put their gear on a low one, like just reduce the gear for 1.5 miles because the road was not very good. Okay, so this is a very important thing. This you have to keep in mind because there is something to do with this thing. Is this line is related, or this line is very important line. This we will find when we will proceed with our story. Okay. Yes. Like the Penchley children went home, like after meeting him, this all of them were back, went home thinking they had seen the last of Lob. It means that they thought that they were not they won't be encountering or coming across Lob again in their life. Okay. Yes, the whole family was playing cards by the fire in front room after supper. Supper, it means the dinner. Okay, when there was a loud thump and crash of china in the kitchen. So it means that there was a kitchen. This mother was working there. Okay, Jane was working there, like she was cooking something. So at that time there was a one window, and who came from that window or who entered there? So that this Lob entered. Okay, and what she was doing? She was preparing a Christmas pudding. So at that time, both the father and mother, they encountered them, that from where this Lob came, and how you all are familiar with him. So they have told about everything, like Mr. Dodsworth is his owner, okay, owner, and he lives there in Liverpool, and every short of description they have given to the father and mother. Okay, so again this Mr. Dodsworth came and he took him away, like he took him back with him to Liverpool. Like a week passed, then one evening suddenly history was repeating itself. Okay, so what happened again? This history was repeating. So what happened that time? Like again, Jean, mother, was walking in the kitchen. That time again, something that something came from the kitchen, and what was there? That Lob again. Okay, so Lob again came, and he started hugging, like this Lob and Sandy started hugging each other. So God heavens, good heavens, exclaimed Jean. Okay, so Jean was exclaiming, and she was shouting that, okay, now from where did he came again? Okay, look at his feet, because it was very dirty. Okay, so after that we find that Sandy run a bowl of warm water while I get the disinfectant. It means that a chemical liquid to destroy bacteria, or we may say that Dettol kind of thing. Okay, so that they will be just washing the feet of this dog, and they will be allowing him to come in their house. Okay, inside the house. Then he flopped down on the hearth rug and slept with his head on Sandy's feet. And like he just went there and hearth rug. What is the meaning of hearth rug? It is a small carpet. Okay, a small carpet or a piece of carpet that is used in order to make the floor safe. Okay, like this you will be basically finding near the fireplaces in Western country. Okay. So next day, Lob's owner, Dodsworth, arrived to take his pet home. Okay, like take his pet home. It means that he came there to take this Lob back to his home. Okay, at that time, after that, all this Tess, Tim, and this Sandy, they were very much disheartened. They were very much upset. So that what this mother Jane, they took them to the circus to watch the circus. So after that, Tim and Tess, they were happy, but this was like Sandy, that nothing can cure Sandy. Okay, she just wanted badly, that she just wanted this Lob to stay with him and always play with her. So Bert Pendley rang up Liverpool again, Mr. Dodsworth. Okay, so this time again we found that in 10 days, after 10 days, after like the whole episode is over, like the circus and all. So after 10 days, what happened? Lob was back again. Okay, he came back again to the place. So out of his furry coat, as if he had met and tangled with an enemy or twice in course of his 400 mile walk, like his torn, like his ear was not in a good condition, and the patch was missing from his furry coat. It means that from his skin, it means that he was there with a fight with his enemy. Okay, so now Bert Benchley again rang to the Mr. Dodsworth, and he talked to him that why your dog used to always come there. That time Mr. Dodsworth said that I'm very busy and it is not possible for me to again come there to the Cornwall and to take my pet back to my home. I think that he likes your family and he's very comfortable with your family and he wants to live with your family. So I just want to gift him and you may keep him with yourself. So at that time this Bert Benchley, so he looked at his daughter's swimming eye. It means that she was again and again crying that she just don't want Lob to go back to Liverpool, okay, to with Mr. Dodsworth. So, and he just agreed then. He said that okay, now what happened, this Lob started living with the new family, that is with with Sandy's family. So here we will finding that one episode, this is very important. Okay, so it was quite a 9 years later on. Okay, so after 9 years, like at that time this Sandy was 5 years old and her brother Don, she was he was 12 years old. So after, you have to directly add plus 9 in both of this. Okay, so it means that this Sandy was a teenager, she came in her teen age. So okay, so like a big girl, a teenager girl she was at that time. What happened to this this Love was also very old now, like he was also a grown up. So there were some changes, like he was not that active as he used to be, like he became little slower, a little stiffer, that movement was not there. There was a touch of gray on his nose. Okay, it means that the color of the heirloom of the nose of this Lob was in gray. Earlier it was some other color, but he was still a handsome dog. Okay, so we can't find that the like he was very old or aged. Okay, but still he was a handsome. So one evening in October, so this is a very important time, that October, that was a time of October and it was evening. So what happened, this is a very like we can say this is the turning point of this happily going story. What happened that day? Like Jean, the mother of Sandy, she came and she said that your aunt, it means that Rebecca, okay, Sandy's aunt. So I have already told you at the beginning only who is Rebecca. Rebecca is Will Hoskins' wife, and at the same time she is aunt, Sandy's aunt. It means that she is the sister of Bert Benchley, okay, sister of Rebecca's father. So that's why she's known as aunt. Like she was alone in the house. Why? Because Will Hoskin, he went for the fishing. Okay, so that's why that time she was alone in the house and she wanted Sandy to come and stay with her. Okay, so like spend the evening with her. That's why she called Sandy. So can I take Lob with him? Lob with me? So who is asking? Sandy is asking to her mother that she wants to take Lob to Rebecca's house. But we know that Rebecca, like her mother is saying that she doesn't like any dog and all, like Aunt Becky's cottage. Like Sandy fastened Lob, yeah, but anyhow that she made her mother agree and she started taking this Lob to Aunt Becky. Becky, it means that Rebecca only, okay, to their home. So after this, we find that Jean is saying like it is a scene of a home, like she was with the twin and she was asking them to just play some cheerful music. And but at the same time, there was a loud music at they have just put the music on a loud volume and there was some incident. Okay, so she was unable to hear or know about that incident just because the music was very loud. What happened? There was one truck, okay? The truck was coming and it collided with the wall of the post office because it was a very high speed truck. The truck's speed was very high, okay? That's why. So at the same time, after yes, here you will find that hustle sound the hill and crash against the post office wall a few minutes. Okay, so she was not able to hear the truck crash. Okay, when this truck crashed to with this post office wall. Okay, so this mother was not able to hear. So now I have also talked about Dr. Travers. Now this comes in the scene that who is Dr. Travers. What is the name of Dr. Travers? Emily. Okay. Wife of Dr. Travers. So Dr. Travers' wife name is Emily. Here you will find it. Emily. Okay. Yes. So he saw the sign that said steep hill. Okay. This sign, I have already told you that this is the notice that you have found at the very beginning of the story. I have told you that to note it down because this is a very important line. Steep hill, low gear for 1.5 miles, dangerous to cyclists. It means that drive slow in normal manner. Okay, so dutifully he changed into second gear. So he used to follow the duties. So as it was written that the road is not good because there is a steep and hilly area, that's why he dutifully changed the gear into the second gear. I noticed a sign on the coast road that said Fisherman's Arms has 2 miles. It means that this is the name of the place. Okay, so they were just generally talking. So after that, Dr. Travers, he looked somewhere, okay, like looked at a stream. So what he has seen, that there was a pile of clothes there near the stream, and Mrs. Travers was out of the car in a flash. So just to look at that, what happened, like something is there in the, like something is lying over there in the stream. They all of this, like Mr. and Mrs. Travers, they came out of the car and they started looking there. She has been hit. It means that they were talking about some girl who was lying there in the stream or below the hill at the steep corner, and she was hit by something, like we don't know what actually hit her. Can't be more than a few minutes, and they were just assuming that this incident might have taken place just before 10 minutes, okay, a few minutes, not more than few minutes. Remember that truck that overtook us 1/2 mile back? So they are just talking about a truck, okay, while they were in their journey when coming to this place. So there was, like, this is their car, so 1/2 mile ago, so one truck came and it overtook them, okay, and it was very in a high speed, like they were saying that speeding like the devil. Okay, so the speed is compared with the devil, the truck's speed. It means that something may happen very bad. Okay, so that was the reason. And we found that this truck came and collided to a post office wall, and due to which they can now we can just correlate that this girl was hit by this truck only. Okay, so it is very clear with this. And again, here we were finding that they took this little girl to the hospital, and police came and they just informed Mr. Pengele, because that was Sandy. Okay, the girl who met the accident with the truck was Sandy. Okay, so, and we cannot find Sandy's dog, like Lob, anywhere around. Okay, so there was no Lob. There is no description of Lob, where he went or what happened to him. Okay, there was only Sandy who was in hospital now, and this police came and police informed to Pengele's, like Bert and Jean, and also Rebecca was saying that horrified Aunt Rebecca went down her brother's house. It means that whose brother? Bert is like Sandy's father. Okay, Bert house. She found the family with white shocked face. Bert and Jean were about to drive off to the hospital, like they were about to go to the hospital where Sandy had been taken, and the twins were crying bitterly. They were just very much horrified. So now Hoskin was Mrs. Hoskin. It means that Rebecca, she was saying that, oh, if I only I had never invited the poor child, like she was saying that she was regretting on the whatever the decision she made. Like she was saying that, okay, it was only just because of me. If I would have not invited the poor child, then she might be in a good condition now. So the nine, okay, so here name of the hospital is the Western Counties Hospital. Okay, so it was a very large hospital. At that the hospital, something strange was happening. Like there was a dog, okay, outside of the hospital, and he just wanted to enter the hospital, okay, but the people or the guard, they thought that he just wants some bread or some food, so they have just provided, but he was not interested, he just want to enter, but it was not allowed for the dogs to come inside. Okay, so here we will finding that there comes Granny Pierce. Okay, so it means that grandmother of Sandy, and to look upon his daughter, sorry, her daughter and son-in-law. So his daughter Jean is daughter and son-in-law is Bert. Okay, so it means that Jean's mother, so her name is Pierce. Okay, so Granny Pierce came, and she anyhow managed to take Lob inside the hospital. Okay, inside the hospital. So she just managed, she talked with the higher authorities and the guard, and later on they have just allowed them, and they both of them like Lob and Granny went inside the hospital where this Sandy was sleeping. So let us look at this. Now here they walked to Sandy's room. Bert and Jean were inside, like father and mother, both of them were inside. Everything was terribly quiet, like there was no sound. Sandy was lying there on the bed very still. It means that without any movement, all Lob's attention was riveted on the bed. Lob let out a faint whine. Faint whine, what is the meaning of whine? It means a loud cry, okay, but faint. It was in a faint condition, like while he was barking at that time, it was like he was howling at someone or he was pleading, anxious, okay, anxious voice was coming. And the sound of that whine, Sandy stood just a little at that whine, like that sound of Lob. So Sandy stirred. It means that there was a slight movement. She sighed. It means that breathed, and her eyes opened, looking at the door. Lob. She was very happy after seeing Lob. And okay, she was calling that Lobby boy. She moved her left arm because her right arm was already, we know that it got fractured, but only her left arm was in good condition. So she took. She started groping fingers. She started loving this dog Lob, and she found that her ear, like Lob's ear, his ear was wet, okay, in a wet condition, like as if he was coming from any of the ocean or any sea or any water body, okay, or of any river. So what happened if we just come, we take bath, so after taking bath, so we used to be wet, okay, so that time only Lob was wet, as if he was coming from somewhere, like some water body. So Granny Pierce led Lob out into the passage again. So after this, when both of them met, so this Granny Pierce, she took this Lob again back to the passage. It means that outside of the room. There he ran off swiftly. It means that Lob ran off swiftly. It means that very fast down the stairs. Bert and Jean had came out into the passage, and again we found that Bert, like father mother, they also came out of the room where she was kept, like Sandy was kept in the hospital, okay. And now listen, this is very important. Now what they were saying, listen mother, said Bert, Lob was killed by same truck that hit Sandy. It means that, yes, now this is a very important line, okay. Yes, like Lob was killed by the same truck that hit Sandy. It means that we know that Sandy met an accident at that day. I have told you about the incident of that truck, that there was one truck who overtook Mr. and Mrs. Travers' car, and after coming here, it collided with a post office wall, and it hit some girl. And who was that girl? That was Sandy. Okay, at the same time, it hit a dog, okay, Lob. It means that Lob. So it means that Lob was no more. He died at the same time when this truck hit. But this is the main thing that about which I was saying, that supernatural element or something that is unexplained, that is beyond the law of the nature. So Dawn found Dawn. Who is Dawn? Dawn is Sandy's brother. Okay, who was earlier 12 years old, but after 9 years, there will be his age is different. So he was dead. So it means that Lob was dead. Okay, Dawn rode, and after that, what Dawn did, like Sandy's brother, he took him into the sea. Okay, and he tied concrete or some stone over his collar so that he will sink inside the water. Okay. So he will get sunk inside the water. So sank him at sea, and after that they are saying that, like, mother is asking, sank him at sea, like you have just put him into the sea, then what? Then how it is possible that this came back? Like, slowly old Mr. Spears and then the other two turned to look at the trail of dripping wet footprints that lead down the hospital affairs stairs. Okay, so after this they have just looked that there from where this let me know that Lob went very swiftly, okay, downside the stair. So when they were looking at that, they found that the footprint of this Lob, it was wet. And it means that it was the spirit of Lob which came to meet this Sandy, because she loves her, okay, and that's why she just wanted to say her final goodbye. That's why we found that he came, the spirit of Lob came there in the hospital to meet her. That's why, as we know that he was already drowned inside like into the water, that's why his footprints were very wet, okay. And that can be easily visible on the floor of the hospital. So in the Pendulous garden, they have a stone. So after everything went okay, there was a, like, on the Pendulous garden, it means that the garden, Sandy's garden, there was a stone for remembrance of this dog. Under the palm tree, there was a palm tree, and there they have just put a stone, and what was written there? Lob, Sandy's dog, buried at sea. And it was written that it is for the remember, like, this is a, that stone was for Lob, and Lob is Sandy's dog. That's why Sandy's dog, buried at sea, who was buried at sea. So this we can find at that stone. Okay. So I think that now the story is very much clear to you, and the question answers I will be sending you, so that you have to write it in your fair notebook. Okay. And if you have any doubt, you may ask me. So have a good day, and